future Scratchers. Welcome to the start of a new series called the How to Do Scratch Tutorials. In this series, there will be tutorials on how to make games on Scratch. But in this tutorial, we're just going to talk about the basics. Do you like the idea? If you do, hit that like button. And if you want to become the Scratch Master, then smash that subscribe button. To get started, let's go to scratch.mit.edu. And sign in if you want to name your game and save it. Recommend signing in, and if you want a video on how to join Scratch, just put it down in the comments below. Now press create. Okay, so step one. We're gonna just explain the whole layout. That's what we're gonna do first. So, see this? This is like the testing side, I call it. Or you can move sprites around to test it, and you can play the game that you've been testing out that you write in the workspace right here. So this over here is the workspace, and this is what I call the testing space, or testing side, or whatever you want to call it. This is where the stages are laying, which if you press this, new blocks will pop up for stages or backdrops. And you can change it right there. We'll talk about that in a later video. Let's go back to the sprite. And now, as you see, this the block palette over here. There's a lot of blocks. It goes all the way from motion to your own blocks, all the way to extensions. So motion is where he moves around and stuff. The looks is the looks, what he does, basically. Like, he can say something, it's a look, it's the looks. It can change a costume, it'll change his look. The size changes look. Now let's go to the costumes. We'll explain this. So here's where you get to edit your costumes. You can zoom in and out with the minus glass and the plus. And press equal button just to see most of everything. As you can see, you can move it. Like, see, all throughout here you can see it in the game. But if you put it out here, you don't see it. So this is just for like purposes, like if you want to put something out here to use later in here, that's why that's out there. And you can explore these tools: paint tool, text tool, eraser tool, and a square tool, an ellipse tool, which is a circle tool, which ellipses or circles. Now let's go to sounds. This is a good part. Now, if this cat sprite starts out with a default sound called it's a meow sound, and you can edit it by making it faster, slower, you can make it louder, softer, you can mute it, and just start from, I don't know what I just did, but you can select a certain part to mute just that part, like, and then you can select a certain part to fade in, fade out, reverse, and then do a robot. You'll like the robot, I'm sure of it. Over here is where you edit the sprite name. You can show or hide it. And the X and Y. The X and Y is where it's placed. X is left and right. It can be left or right. If it moves this way, it'll make it go up. If it moves right, it'll make the number go down. But the Y, if it goes up, the number goes down. If it goes down, the number goes up. It's basically the opposite. Now that we know the parts of the website, and we know what kind of blocks there are, why don't we talk about the certain blocks? So, as you can tell, there's a lot of categories and there's tons of blocks. We're not going to talk about like a lot. We're going to just talk about the basic blocks. So, let's drag out these blocks. Move 10 steps, the go-to block, and the go-to random position, the point towards. Those are the blocks we're going to do in motion. Now let's go to looks. Let's drag the say block, the say for 2 seconds. Let's drag out the set size blocks as set size and change size. And now let's go to the sound and drag out the play sound, meow till done, and the start sound. Now let's go to events and drag out the wing green flag collect. These are all the main blocks. Now let's explain what they do. When you press the green flag, which that starts a project, it doesn't really do anything. Let's switch it to this sprite for now, or it looks like it's running. It doesn't do anything. Let's see when it to move 10 steps. And click the green flag, it doesn't do anything. But if you click a block, it does what the block does. But what if you want to do it when the green flag is clicked? You drag a block under it. And when that black shadowy thing pops up, you just let go, and it goes. So now when you click the green flag, it moves 10 steps. And you can right-click on a block to duplicate or add a comment. If we duplicate it, we can do minus 10 steps. It'll just go forward and backwards so quick, it doesn't even move. Now let's just put the move 10 steps there. Now let's do the go to random position. It'll just go to random position. Just drag that off for now. And now if you do a go to block, it'll just go to a specific position. And then, and let's say it's right there, and you want it to go right there. You look at the X, see that right now it's negative 1. We just do negative 1 there. And in 41, let's type 41 there. Let's say you drag it over here. And then press green flag, it goes right there in the same spot every time. Now the point towards mouse pointer, you'll like it. But it just points towards the flag because that's where your mouse is at that certain time. That's where a really useful block comes in. It's called the forever block. The forever block, it does it forever, and then it keeps on pointing at you. Let's say you don't want it to do it forever. Let's say you only want it to do it for a little bit. Maybe 20 times. Does it 20 times. And then, those are those two blocks, which you can use them like forever, go to random position. And you're in for a big, crazy project. And now there's a set size block. It'll set size to a certain thing. It'll set size to 100, which it's currently at, because that's its default size. You can set it to 150. And you can change the size. For now, let's just set size at the very beginning, before the forever loop. Let's set size to 1. And now it'll be growing. But if you think that's too fast, let's change size by 0.1. And it'll certainly grow. And grow. And I think you can tell, it'll be growing up so quick. In there, let's just for the project's sake, let's just drag this into here and let's just repeat 15 times. And now it's placed on meow until done. Which place on meow, it plays it. And now the start sound, it just starts the sound. It does it 15 times and then plays the sound meow. Now the say block is the final block we're gonna cover for today's video. The say block, it says something, like let's say you want it to say, "Hello, my name is John." We can't see him right now, so let's just set it to 100. Put it there, and if you click the green flag, it'll say, "Hello, my name is John." And then see, if after that 2 seconds is up, it's going to go back to set size to 1, and it's going to repeat 15 times, and then play sound meow until done. But if you want it to say that while it's doing this, you use this say block over here. The say one. You can do, I'm just going to copy this, but when you click it, it'll select all, hold the control key on a keyboard, and press C. Now click this, hold control, press V. And then see, it'll say it the whole time. And it won't ever stop. It matters what kind of project you want. And now you press this trash button to get rid of it. And now there's show and hide, but you can go in and guess what that is. And now you press file, save if you're logged in. But if you're not logged in, this is the interface it'll show. And you sign in. If you haven't signed in before this, you press sign in. And a new stuff will pop up. Like, you'll be able to name it. You'll be able to share it to your friends if you want to show them all the work you've done. You can file, save now. And then let's go press the scratch button right there. And then, if you want to play your project, you press your name and you go to My Stuff. And then, it'll pop up whatever you named it. I didn't really name mine. And then press C inside. And there you go. You just made yourself your own project. You are so good at doing Scratch. You really are going to become a Scratch Master. That's why, if you want to stay up to date and become a Scratch Master, you better hit that subscribe button and like the video if you want to see more of this series. I can say it again. Thanks for watching. See you on the next video. Bye.